Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's talk about iCloud photo sharing in the new Photos app. So the new Photos app, in conjunction with iCloud, makes it very easy for you to share photos so others can see it. They don't have to have the Photos app. They don't have to even be on a Mac. All they need is access to the web. Let's see how we can do this. Notice that on the left sidebar here, you can bring that up with View, Show, or Hide sidebar. You've got your shared activity here. I can bring that up, and I haven't started sharing yet, so I'm going to hit the Start Sharing button, and it's going to prompt me to share an album. So let's create one called Test Share. I'm not going to invite any people right now, and I'm not going to add a comment. I'm just going to create it. And you can see now I've got Test Share. And this activity tab here shows recent things that I've done with sharing. So let's go right to the Test Share here. And you can see it's empty. Let's add photos or videos by clicking there. Now I can go and view all my photos. I'm going to select a couple and I'm going to hit Add. And then it's going to add these to the Test Share album. Great, so it took about 30 seconds and now these three photos are listed as shared here on the Test Share album. And I can now look at this. I can go ahead and add more photos and videos here. I can then use some buttons here at the top. So I can click here and I can change the album name. I can invite some more people and I can set some options. So I can set that subscribers can post. So I can, when I invite people, they can actually post photos of their own here. So you automatically created a shared album that other people can post. A whole family can post photos of a vacation to one shared album here. I can also have notifications here sent to me when people post and do things. And I can check this off and now it's public and it's on a website and I can actually use this link here and I can send that an email to friends and they can go ahead and view it. So I'm going to copy that and then I'm going to open it up in Safari. So here I am in Safari and I can see that at this URL I can see the album here. And anybody can see this. They can be using any browser and they could go in here to this website and view it because I've made it public. So this is a great way to share photos with people like while you're on trips and things like that. You can select any photo to go directly to it and then you can flip through them all. So it's kind of all like automatic here. You can also download an individual photo, go full screen. A lot of functionality in this standardized web page here. So it's important to keep in mind that there are two types of people that will be viewing these when they're public. There's the people that are not invited and they can just view them and download them, do things. But they can't change it. They can't add photos. And then there's people you've invited who should also have the Photos app. And they'll be able to actually see it listed here on the left under Shared and be able to add their own photos. Or if you check this, turn this off here, then they'll just be able to see it and they won't be able to modify it. You can also change the name of the album anytime you want and use this button here to delete it. So the cool thing here is it's so easy to add to this. Let's say I'm looking through my photos collection and decide I want to add this photo right here to it. I can select it and I can hit the share button and say I want to use iCloud photo sharing. And there's that Test Share album I created. I can tap on it right there and now it's added to it. So now if I go to Test Share, I can see that that fourth photo is there. Also, while I'm here, I can select and then delete it. It's going to remove it from the shared album. It doesn't delete it from my photos collection. And I can get rid of it. So it's very easy to change this. So iCloud photo sharing is very simple and very easy and quick to use. So the downside to that is that there are not many options. For instance, there's no way to add captions to these or anything for anybody to read. They just see the photos. There's no way beyond these options to further customize it. Like for instance, if you wanted to have it available on the web but only to certain people, there's no option for that. They either have to be somebody invited and they view it through photos or they can be publicly viewable by anybody that has this URL. So if you really want more options and more things that you can do, of course there are other ways to share photos. You can select some photos and you can do all sorts of stuff. You can share on Facebook and put them up there. You can use Flickr, say. So there's a lot of different options. And of course, beyond the Photos app, there are more options as well. So if you want tons of control and very specific things, then iCloud photo sharing is not for you. But if you want something quick and easy to be able to share with anybody, or have a shared album that a group of people can add to, then iCloud photo sharing is a great option.